Justine Ezarik is our guest. Her new book is iJustine. Great, great book. An analog memoir for somebody who was digital from birth, I think. just an amazing story. If Hollywood came to call, and they are, aren't they? Would you just chuck it all and become a movie star?
I don't think you can do that now. There's no way. If I was just doing movies, like, that would be all I was doing. And there's no way to tell people about the movie. And I think that's why a lot of, you know, Hollywood people and people in traditional television are tapping into this YouTube audience and the social media kind of thing, because we have the audience already. We're going to take the people to see it. And that's why it's awesome doing, for example, like The Price is Right. Yeah, I was on the show. And then now later on, I'm able to take my audience through this entire transition of, you know, being on the show, being a guest host and that kind of thing, and just bringing it all around and telling a full story. And one of the reasons that I even wrote the book was because I kept pitching a web series sort of based around my Justine character, and even potentially a movie or a TV show or something like that. And no one was really understanding what I was saying. So I was like, well, I'm just going to write the book. And then it's like, here we go. Here's the story. This is what I want to make. So I think that's really ideally what I would love to do.
So good. I like that. I like that. But I mean, you have been in Law and Order. You've been in, you've been on Criminal Minds. You've been in The Vampire Diaries, The Bold and the Beautiful.
Oh, of course. Fantastic.
Do you think, I mean, I got to think, and you have an agent, right?
I do, yeah. Mm-hmm.
So you're trying to get more work in TV and film?
Yeah, it's just my main focus is still just doing the internet thing, because really, I mean, when it comes down to it, I mean, this is where my audience is. And
it would be kind of cool if you could take us with you into Hollywood celebrity.
Yeah, and that's what I knew. It's going to be really fun sort of doing this movie, because it's going to be a whole completely different type of thing, and, you know, creating this long form content and taking people behind the scenes and showing them the whole process of creating this film, introducing them to the actors and just showing them everything that goes into it. It's going to be so cool. So I'm really excited about it.
Yeah. When is that start shooting? It's shooting now?
It was supposed to start shooting this week, but it got pushed. So we should be filming after VidCon. So it's going to be fun.
And do you have a major role in this?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so me and another one of my friends were the two leads.
Oh.
And then also,
do you get
producing.
Killed?
I don't get killed this time. This is great. Everything that I always do,
I kind of made a career of lying on the sidewalk. So not anymore, huh?
No. But Hollywood is interesting. And a lot of people now, like kids, when they're watching TV or watching content or watching movies, you know, they're watching the TV, but to them, TV is not cable television. It's Netflix, it's Amazon, it's podcasts, it's YouTube videos.
I bet you more people, in fact, you said before the show that you have a lot of kids show up at your book readings and signings. I bet you more people of that generation know you as Passion Fruit.
Yeah,
right?
I was on The Annoying Orange. Yes, very fun.
I bet you that's, honestly, I mean, kids love Annoying Orange.
They do, yeah.
I don't know why.
I love that
It's
show.
Annoying, I guess.
Exactly, that's the point.
annoy your family and friends.